Hello and welcome back to CubeVR. If you can see this video, that means you survived 2020 and you are now in the year 2021. Happy New Year! Well, last year wasn't the best year for all of us, but it can only get better by now. So yeah, New Year, new plans. Today I'm gonna finish this little stairway here, and then I'm actually going to make a stairway to the island up there, and I'm planning to use glass as a staircase, and I just wanna go up there because this island is standing right in front of me the whole time and I was never up there. Look at all these birds. They know what's coming. Yeah, I will actually start to make the stairway somewhere there and just build up. So it will probably take like a whole episode just to make the staircase, but it should be pretty awesome because I increased my view distance once again. I am now at a view distance of 200 and I can show you how it looks. Actually, before the video I was running around for 5 hours. Wait, I go to the other... Come on. Oh, there's a hole. Nice. Nice little cave. So, I'm just going to show you how far I can see now. It was really hardcore to walk all the distance. And wait, I still need to turn on the music, because when I was walking around for hours, I was listening to some VTuber music streams. Oh, look at this, that's nice. Can you see these mountains? It's really bright because of the sun. This mountain is almost the edge of the 200 view distance. It took me about 10 minutes straight walking just to get there. So yeah. It's actually really far away. I didn't walk too much in this direction because it's actually easier to go through the desert, because desert is nice and don't have this much mountains except this. Actually, behind the mountain there you can see is another mountain, and behind there are even more plains and mountains and more desert. There's a lot of desert here. You can't see because of the sun. Actually, behind there are some really nice looking mountains. They actually really does look like this cutout thingy. It's really nice. And back there, behind the glorious sun rays, is actually a really nice mountain range. So yeah, it's really nice. And I think when I go up there, I can overlook almost everything. This huge view distance is really nice. Look at how far I can see. Actually, when I was behind this mountain, I always used this mountain as a beacon. But I couldn't see the mountain because of this mountain, and I was like, I think you need to go to your left. Then I turned left, walked a bit, and then I was like, oh my god, where am I? Who am I? And why am I? I couldn't see anything. So I just took some sand blocks and then I built a really tall tower just to overlook all the mountains. Then I found my Beacon Mountain And that's when I got back here, and then I was actually behind this mountain. I started there, was thinking that I always look at this mountain, and I ended up there. So yeah, navigation without a nice looking beacon or some point you can have your focus on can be pretty hard. But this huge view distance is really, really cool. Doesn't even take this much power anymore. Oh, was this thing here before? I can't remember seeing you. Actually, there are a lot of flying, pebbles. I don't know. Just some random dirt blocks. Actually, this dirt block with the tree on it was a really nice point to focus on. Helped me a lot when I was back there. Oh, now when the sun is going down, you can actually see a bit better over the desert. I like these borders. Actually looks like horticultured rice fields. Maybe I can make some sand cakes here, like an industrialized production. Ah, now you can see the mountains appearing from behind the desert. Oh, this looks really cool. Let me get up a bit more. Doesn't this look cool? That's really beautiful. I always loved the twilight, and the twilight in Cube VR is so special. It actually really feels warm when you see the sun going down, everything turning orange. Actually, it's a really nice start in the new year, seeing the sun going down. It's actually a New Year's tradition to watch the first sunrise of the year in Japan, and I'm doing the total opposite. I'm watching the first sundown of the year. So first I'm going to make the stone staircase that I started last episode. I just want to have at least this thing finished. And then I'm going to make glass. Do I have some coal? Not that much. And I don't have any torches. So actually, we don't have this much coal. Could be a problem, but maybe not. I will not have any problems with the sand because of these huge deserts I have everywhere. So I think it's best to start here. And I need some torches, it's getting dark. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I found another YouTuber who is making QVR videos. He does it without any commentaries, just playing the game. It was actually really okay. He started to make a cave in the mountain, and he had a really nice entrance. Looked really cool, so maybe I'm going to copy his work. Do we have cobblestones? No. Why don't we have cobblestones? Actually, it's wallstone. Why don't we have wallstones? I'll go into my normal mining spot here. Here it is. So, pew 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 pew. So. So, that's nice. Stone is always nice. Actually, today is New Year's Eve. Is it called New Year's Eve? It's called Sylvester. It's actually it's the last day of the year right now. And there are actually some people out there making some noises and stuff and having some sparks and stuff. And I have my own sparks right here. Look, sparkle, pew. So, I think this should, that's more than enough. I saw that some people suggested, that we get some kind of auto crafter, because it's a core to craft your own recipes every time. But actually, I don't think it's that much of a problem. After some time, you get pretty used to it, and it's not that hard. And I mean, you don't craft furnaces all day long, so that's okay. Most of the basic recipes have really basic structures. Sixty-four sounds nice. 64 is nice, okay. This way? No, this way. Okay. So. I made the torches so that it's not this dark. But if I don't use them, it's pretty useless. So, actually, I should have a fully charged crystal. Will we still have some night time? I guess. Okay. Ah! So. Okay, that's better. Can't wait to see this whole world from up above. So, and here. Let there be light. And now it's becoming daytime. Nice. This the right height? Oh, I went up a bit too high. So this way, okay. I'm just going to collect all the dirt so that I can dispose of it later on. So. Cleaning up after your work is always important. Just keep it clean and simple. So, over the past couple of days, I watched a new YouTube channel with a guy who is using some iron detector to search for junk in like children play spaces and stuff. It's actually really interesting. He's going around to different play spaces and play areas, collecting all the dirt. He also once dived in a river, and there he collected a lot of throwaway junk and some necklaces and bracelets. It was pretty surprising to see what people can lose. This looks okay. So. Nice. Actually, this turned out better than I thought it would. Nice. So let's see, maybe we have some coal here? Not really. We have some less left. I will put some dirt in here because I can. Wahaha. So I don't need this one. We don't need this much dirt. So I'll keep the rest. Sand is pretty important. Some flagstones. So I'm going to take the glass with me. So I will let the crystals just lying here. They can charge. So I would say let's go to the furnace and start producing our first glass. Hey there, little bunny. Actually, I was thinking about making a short video using the rabbit clip from Ghost Stories. But I don't know if I should bring this or not, because there might be some people who could get offended by the English dub from Ghost Stories. But it's actually just funny. So, I don't know. Maybe I will try it, and when the backlash is too much, I can still remove the video. Me? Where's my furnace? It should be here somewhere. Ah, maybe here. Because of this huge view distance, the actual relation, how far you can move, is not that easy, so let's just add some sand. Pew 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 pew. '18, '19, '20. Good. Now going down here. Come on. Oh, old man. Get down. At first I'm going to use 20 coal and some wood. Oops. Actually right now my left hand was drifting around because there was only one base station who could actually see my hand. And even this base station got covered by my right leg, so okay, now. So okay, it's heating up. Actually, some people said that they didn't understand how the furnace works. But for me, it's actually pretty self-exploration? That's not even a word. Self-explanationary, blah, 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 blah. Well, it explains itself pretty nice, I think. So, let's go to the desert, get some sand. While the first batch of sand is melting, I can collect a bit more sand. Hmm, there's an island floating around. So much sand. Sand everywhere. New mega project, melting all the sand in the desert. And then replacing the sand blocks with glass. So. Come here. So. We have 75. So still 5 more. At least we have 80 cent. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, nice. The only thing we still need now would be a lot of wood, so I can keep the furnace burning. I will just check the process right now. Maybe it's already finished and I can make the second batch of glass. And while the second batch is still melting, I can cut down some of these trees. Let's see. 75%. We could need more heat, so I'm just putting in more wood. A higher heat percentage would mean faster melting. So. Okay, heat is going up. Nice.
Dann. There it is. Nice. Come on. Nice. Let's see. Melting process should start pretty soon. There it is. Nice. 108%. We still have some wood that we can burn. Actually, we have 137 dark wood. Should be plenty. And we have a lot of glass ingots we can use to make glass blocks. Hmm? That's it? Wait. Let me double check. Oh, it actually is? Hmm, that's nice. Hmm. That's actually plenty. So how much glass would I need? I think I should start with at least 500 blocks. Inventory is almost full. Let's see. Oh, we're already at 100% again. Nice. That's fast. Maybe we could even still get another melting process done. Nineteen, 20, okay. I was just thinking maybe if I use the blow function of the bucket I could cool off the iron or the glass faster. I should probably test it out someday in the future. Oh, as you can see, I already have 19 rainbow dye again. Because while I was exploring, I found a lot of rainbow flowers. Just the exploring would actually had granted me 10 episodes of Let's Plays. So be glad that I didn't record it. Me running around in circles. Ah. We need a bit more. So. What a nice way to make space in the inventory. So heat is going up. Nice. It's getting late. just close the hatch, so. Okay, heat is still going up a bit. Okay, now we reach the peak, it's going down. But it should still be enough to get the melting process done. Progress, not process. So, come on. And... done. The class is actually really eager to get out here. So, let's go. Oh, nice. I still have some time, so we can actually start with the glass staircase. I'm going to make it out of glass because I don't want to see the staircase from everywhere. Because imagine you're seeing this really beautiful floating guy island. And then you have a jiggly, not that good looking staircase. Okay, I have enough space for two more. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now I have 644 glass blocks. Should me get at least halfway up? Maybe not even that. Maybe that's enough for 1/3? Let's see. Maybe I can start with a 2-block staircase and then just increase the numbers. But I would like to use 3-block staircases. Maybe if I use the crystal placing block, I can generate some glass blocks and maybe this will help. Maybe. So, one of the biggest problems, where do I start to reach the top? Should I start from here and make it this way, or should I start there and make it this way? Actually, I think it would be better to start or to get there, so this way, because on this way I have to go up to the highest part, and here I can just carve myself like a stone staircase, maybe even in the rocks or something. So I think I will start here. We just need to find a good place to start. So... oh. Desert everywhere. You think I should start here? He was wiggling his tail when I was hit his butt. So, nom 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 nom. So... I don't know. Maybe it's good from here. I just noticed that my white lens is starting to flicker. Doesn't look nice. I will test if I got this flicker on other applications as well. And maybe I have to return the HMD. Maybe I should start here. Oh, what? I'm just going to start now. Because I still have some time before my 40 minute mark. So. Actually, it's going pretty fast. So I can at least finish next episode. Maybe even expand to a 3 or 4 blocks staircase. Oh! Actually, it almost looks like I would miss the island. When I go... Wait, let's just see from here. If I go up this way... Nah, should be okay. Oh. That was a bit much. So. So, let's just go up. I know it's dark and you don't see that much, but there is actually not much to see. So... Actually, I think I started too far away. Because it seems like we would actually be too high if I continue in this pace. But let's see how it will turn out. You can see the mountains there. It's really, really cool. I want to build so much, like I said before, I want to make the Cheyenne Mountain Complex from Stargate. And maybe some nice underground cave or something. So. This game has so much potential. But because I'm not that much of an artist, I'm limited to just my imagination. So. But we have a lot of really good builders in the CubeVR community. So I think it will be actually okay. And when the multiplayer starts, a lot of the good builders will definitely start building some really nice community stuff. For example, Quoi, he is such a fantastic builder. He can make so much good stuff out of nothing. I'm really envious. And he's actually started to upload his streams to YouTube. That means now there are a lot of YouTube videos with CubeVR. Which is actually nice, because of this CubeVR will get a lot of recognition. And the more people know about CubeVR, the better. At least that's what I think. Because when the community is growing, the interest in the game will actually start. And when more people like this game, more people will make custom blocks for the game. And that's something we all benefit from. The CubeVR community did grow steadily over the last 2 years. It's nice to see the community grow, and it's just a really welcoming community. You get help from all the community members on Discord. It's really nice to be there. Sometimes I'm just reading what others say there. It's really nice. It's like having some really nice friends you can hang out with. And maybe by the end of 2021 we will have the first test for the multiplayer. Who knows? So it's so beautiful. I can still remember when I started. Actually, there's the starting point. And I was walking around, then I saw this floating island, and I was like, oh, that's so cool, I want to build here. And now I can see it this much, and actually it feels like this mountain is really close. This feels like it's really close. Even these mountains don't feel like they are this far away, but they are. And believe me, like I said, 10-minute walk just to get there. And that's just, maybe it's because I'm playing this game for over a year with few distance of 20 or 40, I think 40, and now these increased few distance, it's just cool and awesome and beautiful. And I don't know if I mentioned this before, but I do love CubeVR. It's a really nice game. It actually helped me a lot over the last year, because I couldn't play Beat Saber anymore, and Beat Saber was my daily purpose to get to work and go home, because I was working 6 or 7 days every week. You sometimes lose track of time, so you don't know what time is it, what day of the week is it. Do I still have a crystal? Not cool. Okay, like I said before, the distance don't feel this distant at all. Look how far I already got. Oh, you know what? These stairs just reminds me of Fate Hollow Ataraxia. There you have the staircase to the moon, or the moon-like thing in the sky. It's really nice. Actually, Summer Abigail von Fate Grand Order descended. Ooh, there are a lot of presents. Pew. That's actually okay.
Oh, wait. Can I... Can you see this part? Right now the sun is a bit annoying. Let's try the other side. This just looked like a double helix. Like some kind of DNA. Oh, ooh, look. That's so cool. That's cool. That's so pretty. Going up and up and up and up. I did a pretty good job. Going up double takes so long. Nice. So nice. Okay, Glitch. When I'm up there, I'm going to make a glass plateau like you have in the, I think it was the Grand Canyon, where you have this glass plateau where you can stand on and look right down the Grand Canyon. I'm going to make this up there as well. And then I'm always going to jump down. Actually, I could try to make a hole in the ground and dig down to the bedrock. And then I can just jump from the highest point down to the bedrock. We have a game height of 800 blocks. So I could actually fall down 400 meters. That's more than the Tokyo Skytree. No, the Skytree is about 600 meters. So, I'm sorry. But I think it was the Tokyo Tower with 300 and something. Or even the Eiffel Tower should have about 300 meters. I don't know. I'm bad with numbers. Oh, this will be so awesome. Yeah, I can't wait to finish this. So, we still have plenty of glass left. I'm just going to charge the crystals here. And once all these crystals are full, I will go back to the stairs. I can't see them from here. Not now. Well, okay, like I said in the beginning, Happy New Year. I just hope that we will continue to have a great year together. I hope that I can improve the quality of my videos, and I'm planning on making even more videos over the year with a lot of other VR stuff. Like, I want to play a lot more Phasmophobia. So, but playing alone is a bit scary, so I have to rely on my friends to play with me. Still going to do some other VR stuff. I have a lot of VR games that I played once and could actually play more, like Galgen. It's a rail shooter. It's actually pretty funny. I made a video about this because it was an anime parody. The title of the mission was "My Little Sister Can't Be This Cute." That's actually the title of an anime series. So, what I wanted to say, over the year I'm going to try to get more content to my YouTube channel, because VR is really fun and it's still not
at a point where everyone knows that we are all good. A lot of people still think that you just strap a display in front of your face, but that's not it. And yeah, I just want to show how beautiful we all can be, because most of the time people see shitty graphic VR games and they say VR is ugly, but we all know Half-Life Alyx top-down the best VR game. And then you have beautiful looking games like Cube VR, where you can spend hours just looking at the surroundings. And yeah. Okay, enough talk for today. We still have a whole year to cover all the small talk. So yeah, as always, thanks for watching, stay healthy, and till next time, bye! Soon.